Bikepacking shoes, oval chain rings, and a new mini Pertura rack. Those are the three products I'm going to be taking a look at on this fine Tuesday. Welcome back, Pathless Peddlers. And if you're new to the channel, if you're into the non-competitive side of cycling, you have found your people, hit that subscribe button. So over the last couple of months, I've had the chance to review a couple of products and have used them enough to kind of share my impressions with you. And the first one is a bikepacking specific shoe. This is the S240 by the brand DZR. If you're not familiar with DZR, they make bike shoes that don't look like bike shoes. Many of their shoes, not all of them, have some capability to take an SPD if that's how you roll. They tend to also be a little bit stiffer in the forefoot for more pedaling efficiency. I've been riding in the S240s for the last couple months, both in Los Angeles and down in Tucson, and these are my likes and dislikes of the S240. First big like is the styling. I love kind of this Danneresque hiking boot light. Pretty classic styling aesthetically if you don't want something that screams athletic shoe while you're cycling. Overall, the build is really nice. I'm not quite sure what the material is, but it feels like a nubuck kind of suede type layer. Very supple, very soft. I really didn't need any break in time with this shoe. It just kind of nicely wraps around the foot. In terms of fit, at first I was a little bit concerned that they would be too narrow, having experience with like some Vans and Converse shoes in the past. Those style shoes tend to be narrow on my foot. Thankfully, however, these are a little bit on the wider side. I wouldn't call them a wide shoe. I think they're wider than something like a Giro, but not as wide as a 510. So it generally fits normalish foot sizes. I found the fit to be pretty true to size. So I typically wear a men's size 9 US, and the Euro 42 fit great. So another thing I really like about this shoe is the general construction. You know, I've had for the last couple months, there's been no fraying. Typically with sneaker style shoes like this, usually you will see the rubber start to pull away from the upper, and it hasn't. It seems super secure. You know, it's sewn in as well as glued. I have a pair of 510s with a similar construction, and those shoes are starting to give out a little bit where there's a lot of toe flex. But so far in the DZRs, the construction seems solid, and there's just no sign of this rubber side area peeling off. So big plus right there. So while this shoe does have the capability to take an SPD, I actually wore it primarily just in flats mode. So I didn't remove this little rubber plate here, and it worked pretty good. I definitely felt the additional stiffness. When you're riding an SPD shoe, you do want that stiffness, not just for pedaling efficiency, but also when you click in and out, you want it pretty rigid so it's not twisting the rubber as you try to get your foot in and out of the pedal. So as a flat pedal shoe, I think it worked pretty well. You do feel that stiffness when pedaling, slightly uncomfortable, but not terrible, not a deal breaker. As the name S240 suggests, this is their shoe for kind of short overnight trips. I can't really speak to how durable it would be on a super epic trip, but I think if you're going from coffee shop, remember those, to campground and back, then this is a great shoe that will fit into your casual everyday wardrobe, but you can also get it dirty and take it on day rides and that overnight bike camping trip. So great shoe by DZR. The first shoe I've tried from this brand. So far, pretty impressed with the construction and just the general supple feel of the upper. Would like to see this come out in a just flat pedal version as well. Next up is the Absolute Black 38 tooth oval chain ring. That's right, ovals are back. I know a lot of you are gonna be telling me that it's, you know, BioPace all over again, but if you do any kind of reading, it's a little bit different. BioPace, if you look at those chain rings and overlay them with the modern oval, those actually tend to be roundish squares, if you will. And also the orientation of the long sides is completely different than the modern oval chain rings. There's a lot of supposed advantages to an oval chain ring. The big one a lot of people talk about is that it takes away that dead spot. So is it true? Is it hype? These are my impressions of riding with the Absolute Black oval chain ring over the last couple months. So first off, if you have a bike with apex cranks, there is one you know, absolute functional advantage, and it is that you can get a smaller chain ring than 42 teeth. For whatever reason, SRAM Apex cranks, they don't make chain rings smaller than 40. So if you do want to go sub 40, 38, absolute black oval chainring is the only option. So in terms of real and not imagined or theoretical advantages, that is a real advantage if you want lower gearing on your bike. Installation is pretty straightforward. I was able to install it without removing the cranks. In terms of how it feels when you're actually pedaling, it was most noticeable on the first times I rode with the chainring. On the downstroke, I felt a slight slackening in the tension and the pedal stroke would accelerate. Whether that translated into actual performance gains, honestly, I'm not sure. I didn't have a great way to measure that. I will say by the third or fourth ride, I didn't really notice it. And what was surprising was going from oval back to a round chainring and back, there wasn't a big difference in my opinion. So yes, a little bit odd at first, but you will adjust. So to be honest, I couldn't detect a massive difference between a round chainring and an oval one. If anything, I don't think it detracted from the riding experience or my performance. I think the biggest plus is that if you want lower gearing on something like Apex or even on a pre-existing crankset, like let's say Tiagra 105, Shimano drivetrain, and it's not the newer GRX, which comes with the subcompact cranks, you can retrofit 4630 using the absolute black system. There is one downside someone pointed out on the one by system specifically is, let's say you have massive mechanical failure and you have to set up your bike single speed. You can't actually do that because of the change in chain tension slack when running one by. So there's that. And lastly, the cool new mini rack by Crust Bikes. I love this rack because it's kind of a combination between a traditional rein enduring rack and a mini porteur. So you have kind of a wider, boxier platform, but you still have the tombstone. So if you have a bag like the Swift Industries, a rando bag or something from Velo Orange, it'll slip over the tombstone. The rack also has lots of mounting points, so it's very easy to attach something like a headlight. Also unique to this rack is that it's got two sets of really adjustable tubular stays. Typically, rando racks have fixed struts, and the third attachment point is through the crown of the fork. With the Crust Rack, you have four adjustable struts in total, as well as a fork crown mount. So super secure and super flexible. So probably the coup de grace of this rack is the adjustment points on the struts. It's got both a narrow and a wide setting. So if you have a bike with, you know, regular normal fork blade width, then you can fine tune the rack for that. But if you're also running it on a plus size bike or a fork with just generally more spacing, you can set it in the wider setting and attach the rack to the bike without the struts being all janky and flexed out in weird angles. If there are any negatives to the rack is that the struts, if you're OCD, the struts do not match the rack color. It'd been great if the struts were black to go along with the black platform. I don't care too much. It's not a deal breaker for me, but I know some people are super matchy matchy. And one other negative is I wish the struts were a little bit longer just so I could fit it on more bikes and that they were solid and not hollow. Just because I find that with the way the struts are set up on my bike currently, I can't use the plastic end cap. So there's just this big gaping hole, ready to catch rain. Again, not a huge thing. You can pick up, you know, spare struts. I think QBP sells some salsa struts, or you can go get struts from Tubis and Ortlieb and all that stuff. So not a deal breaker, but something I would change personally. So what do you think of these products? Let me know in the comments below. If you want to see more accessory and bike reviews, check out these two playlists. And if you like this content, consider supporting the channel via PayPal or Patreon. Keeps this whole show afloat. And as always, guys, stay safe and keep the supply side down.